big contest there. As we said, Nikki Wetman, who's playing six for Cambridge, she did captain the side last year. And that was when Cambridge came away 52-0 winners. But at the moment, it's Sophie Trott for Oxford down the far side. She gets up again, and that was clear again by referee. Not held, but eventually bundled out into the far side. So an opportunity again. Cambridge seem to be having a lot of running ball, but whenever Oxford get it, they are making the yards and pinning them back.
Yeah, Cambridge are defending quite narrowly, so Oxford making ground every time they move the ball out wide at the moment. Cambridge probably just need to get their heads up from the breakdown area and look and see where the spaces are out wide.
Well, we see a move here from Cambridge. No, they're going to keep it tight in the forwards once again. It's Elgar, her nickname Algie to her teammates. Coleman. Still not keen to ship this ball at all yet, Cambridge. They're going to keep it tight. Nothing risque yet about their play. Mark's had to do a little bit of tidying up there, though, so the fly half coming in. Just a very shallow at times, Mark's. Knock on, but referee says play on.
Ready.
And certainly that was going backwards by Cambridge, and what a position we have now for Oxford.
Yeah, very, very good pressure from Oxford in defence, not letting Cambridge have any time on the ball. It was the pass in the end, wasn't it, from Molly Byrne that put the ball receiver under pressure, but a brilliant attacking opportunity for Oxford. And that first scrummage was pretty even, wasn't it? So they'll like to think they've got a pretty good attacking platform there.
18, please.
Big moment then for Oxford. Remember, they didn't get a point at all here last year.
I need you to make sure you're at a level height with your shoulders above your hips. Just make sure you're level for me,
please. Sophie Trott at fullback for Oxford, prowling back and forth behind the scrummage. There she is now, stood with her hands on her hips, but she's been moving back and forth, trying to fool the Cambridge defence about where she's planning to come into the line.
And she is one of the stars of this Oxford side. And that's a big push from Oxford. He does eventually get to the back and they switch the direction. They're not going to use Trott's side. Bean now taking it on.
Lost the contest. Rock! No hands.
There's a little hand that went in there from a Cambridge player, but I think she just got away with it.
Five roll.
Still Cambridge ball.
Ball's available. Five.
Big directions coming in from Bliss. He just needs that ball a little bit quicker. Ashley Loken unable to connect there. And that's the end of the flow there by Oxford, and it'll be a Cambridge scrum.
Yeah, small knock-on and a wasted opportunity from Oxford, really. They never found the go forward in the movement off the scrummage. It was always quite sideways. The passes pushing the players wide.
So you can maintain that, please.
And just not hitting the line at pace. So chance for Cambridge to clear.
Ashley Loken there, she is a bit of a YouTube star, actually. It's the spoken word.
Is that right?
Yeah, I was watching it last night. I was very impressed. If anyone wants to check her out.
Crouch. Bind.
Perhaps good for an interview Set. After the game.
Most certainly. Big push again there by Oxford. Cambridge do manage to get their desserts, though.
Tackle.
Rock! No hands.
Long way for Cambridge to go here, and they are continuing to utilise the forward effort. They go around the corner again. It's the Canadian Wetman, who appears to be one of their go-to ball carriers already.
Okay.
With only 10 minutes on the clock here and no score at Twickenham.
Hold there. It's a good contest.
Marks. And that is just a big maze of players that Marks ran straight into there.
Turnover is good.
She did well, to be fair, not to run into her own player, but that looks like it's been turned over by Oxford. Is this the opportunity? Can they get it out wide quickly? Copley's not passing it yet. It's still Copley going for Oxford. Big hit coming in there by the captain, Middleton. She could have saved something important there. It needs to come away and quickly. Crawling along the ground there. Big call there that it was held, needs to be released. Wonderful hard yards being worked there by the forwards. Loose on the ground, penalty to Cambridge. It was being won there and turned over.
Holding on, blue, six blue, holding on.
And there you go, holding on the penalty, and I think Cambridge got out of danger there.
great work from Cambridge at the break down there to turn it back over. But the feature of this game, Cambridge running it from here. They neglected to clear the ball early, which is what gave Oxford that chance. And again, running the ball from deep inside their 22, playing with fire.
It's come forward.
Oh, this is going from side to side. No one can hold on to their own ball at all at the moment. Sue, could a little bit of what we're seeing here just be the fact we're playing at Twickenham, there's nerves out there?
Yeah, and I think it's huge inexperience. One person that isn't inexperienced, though, is Alice Middleton, Cambridge fullback. What a tackle when Copley was descending on the line. Brilliant. But what I think we're seeing, in answer to your question, is a lot of inexperience. What you don't do at Twickenham in the first 15 minutes of the game is try and run the ball from your own 5 metre line. You've got to clear that ball. You've got to get it out. You've got to play the territory.
Oxford ball. Going down the far side again. Bliss does manage to gather, slightly ran round her own player there, but referee happy there was no obstruction. Popped off ball once again, still going through Bean now.
Tackle release. Thank you, stay there.
Bliss looks up. Supporters there. Robinson this time. Bliss again, Wilcock down the line. Copley finds Ashley Loken. She's powerful. Does well to hold on.
Rock. Ball's out.
Copley again, loops around.
Rock! Onside.
Pierce with good body position to place it back, but again, it's slightly slow here for Oxford. They've got numbers on the far side. It's not coming quick enough, though, and that was an overlap missed.
Ball has gone forward.
Yeah, they're getting a little bit flat, Oxford. Huge amounts of ball in attack, but they're not getting the ball out into the wide open spaces we were talking about a little bit earlier. When they're turning the ball over, you've really got to move it out into space before the opposition can get themselves set.
There's a familiar face, Gary Street, the Oxford women's head coach. He took on the role last year, has continued into this year. And of course, you might know him better for winning a World Cup with England in 2014.
Indeed, he's got one or two achievements under his belt already, but how he would love a varsity match victory at Twickenham to go with all of those.
Oh, again, a little bit of a tangle there for Cambridge. Both sides have been guilty of that now, just getting in front of each other, but referee happy that, again, no obstructions caused. Play can continue. Johansson, who wasn't expected to start today, the Swede is wearing four there. She was meant to start on the bench, but because of that injury and reshuffle, she has ended up starting today. But the penalty, and we're going to have a shot at goal, and this is significant. As we said, Oxford did not get any points on the board last year, and this will be significant if they can score this.
Yeah, you can completely see why they've taken this decision and aim to get not just points on the board, but the first points on the board in this game. And it's fair to say Oxford have been dominant in the first 15 minutes. Cambridge have been pinned back here for the last five, so they'll be desperate to come away with a few points here.
So this is Catherine Wilcock, the captain, stepping up for this first penalty opportunity for Oxford. She's studying history, and she's at Wadham College. And she's got points on the board for Oxford, who now lead here.
Ladies,
just looking on.
Water off, please. Water off.
Penalty is awarded when a team has offended in a game, and that would be a more serious offence than a knock-on, a forward pass or an accidental offside. A deliberate infringement would result in a team being awarded a penalty, so the penalty will go against the team that has offended. Players must be on their feet in the ruck and can only use their feet to ruck the ball back. So any player that uses his hands in the ruck after the ruck is formed will be penalised. When you enter a tackle, ruck or maul, you must enter from behind the hindmost foot of your own players in that phase of play. And if you enter in front of the hindmost foot, then that's regarded as a side entry and will be penalised. Offsides, there are different offside lines in the game. You have an offside at the ruck and the maul, which are the hindmost feet, and that line runs right across the field. At scrums and lineouts, the offside line for people not in the lineout are 10 metres back from the lineout. And from the scrums, it's 5 metres back from the number 8 feet. If anybody encroaches those offside lines, then they get penalised. In rugby, the game is played on your feet. If you go off your feet deliberately in the contact area, for example, then you're known to be going off your feet and you get penalised. In the tackle area, once you're tackled, the tackler and the ball carrier must place the ball and make an attempt to roll away, and the tackler must release the ball carrier and then roll away from that area if possible. When you're tackled and you go to ground, you must do three or four things with the ball. You can either release the ball immediately, you can place it in any direction, or you can pass it off the floor or roll it back to your opponents. In a scrum, the front row must drive straight and drive square, and they must not drive lower than the hips or drive the scrum up. So if you pull the scrum down, you get penalised.
A magic touch, and that could be the decider.
Yeah, it's a really close, it's a great matchup between these two teams. This scrummage, vital. Cambridge have really got the upper hand, haven't they, in the last few minutes, or the last 10, 15 minutes at scrummage, and Oxford really need to clear their lines.
Who'd have thought that one penalty, perhaps in the first half, could be the difference? Bean. Oh, well stolen. Great stuff for Cambridge. And again, they keep it tight again. There were numbers out there. Pearce took it nice and close to the forwards. I do just wonder if it had been stretched there. This time it's going away. Charlton gets the ball away. Marks looks up. Suggett looks up as well. Middleton is there. They need that last pass away. Farrant now. Farrant, can she make it? Can she back herself? Farrant still going. Oh, Sophie trying to take a bow. I think she might have injured herself in the process of taking Farrant out. What a hit. What a try-saving tackle.
Another excellent hit from Sophie Trott. I think she's winded herself rather than anything. You can see her pointing,
right, she's off the pitch.
Pointing
there
saying,
oh, but
winded.
It could all be about fitness now as well. You have to say, some of the women out there, they are looking tired. Who wants it more? Still 10 minutes to play. Can Oxford hold on to this small lead? Can they hold out this Cambridge onslaught? Ball is out. Byrne looks up, finds Marks. Charlton there. Referee has not said it's gone forwards. She's playing on. Marks again to Charlton, out to the far side to Middleton. She's got Farrant outside. Does she use the pass? She doesn't.
10 move.
Could Farrant have made it? Marks has to keep it tight, wait for the forward support to come. Pratt. That's messy. It was a maul that was called, and that will be an Oxford ball.
Oh, it's getting exciting now, isn't it? The crowd you can hear getting behind both teams. The Cambridge game plan at the moment seems to be create a solid platform and get the ball to Alice Middleton. It's a potent combination of Middleton and Farrant when they play together. At the moment, I think Middleton just tempted to try and do it herself. What have Oxford got at this scrummage? Can they repel the waves of Cambridge attack?
I do also just wonder if that last passage of play, if Middleton had just got that pass off. There's a few little moments like that that I think if Cambridge don't come away with the spoils, they might just haunt them. Ball has come away cleanly, still flying away. This is good from Oxford. Nice work by Rose. And we have lost also the scrum half for Cambridge. They tried to clear the ball away there. It's been knocked on by Cambridge, so we'll restart with the Oxford scrum, but there's a bit of treatment going on to Molly Byrne at the moment, who's down injured on the far side. And remember, of course, Cambridge, when they started the day, we thought Lydia Thorne was going to be playing nine for them. But she picked up a pretty nasty ankle injury when they last turned out against Exeter, and she wasn't declared fit this morning. So Byrne had to move from the back row into scrum half. And if they lose her as well, I think someone might be learning scrum half quite quickly.
Yeah, they absolutely don't want to lose her. It doesn't look like they're going to. It's the it's the classic rugby injury. Plug the nose up, get on with the game. You've only got to last another 8 minutes or so.
Time back on. Knock on.
We've
by
all been
white
there.
Scrum blue.
Molly Byrne is now fashioning the plug stotters, we'll call them.
Stability,
for now.
Please.
They always look the best on the telly, and in the post-match pictures,
bind.
It's just what you want.
Set.
It's all glamour, this game. So Oxford have managed to get themselves out of a real bit of hot bother, although this is a big scrum. Somehow Carly Bliss eventually got it, but that is a strong penalty pulled down there. And Molly Byrne is desperately trying to go and get that ball. What a scrum.
Yeah, Oxford not getting the quick hook, which is what they really need. And interesting, not choosing to go Cambridge for the points there.
Interesting that they could have gone for a line out as well, but there's a little bit of white line fever, you feel, for Cambridge here. They're getting frustrated, and Cambridge have won back the ball straight away.
Tackle release.
Hodges.
Scrum advantage is over.
Trot. She's dancing down the whitewash, and it comes out on this near side. And it's been taken quickly here by Cambridge.
It's been touched. I'm afraid you can't go quickly. Line out here. That's your mark.
What a decision from Cambridge. Not to go for the points to post, not to go for the line out, catch and drive, but to run it. Huge decision there with 7 minutes to go to try and get themselves over. Maybe it's simply because they're trying to go for the win.
They do manage to find their women. As Marks just has to double check herself, but still holds on to it. Suggett.
Scrum advantage.
Gibson there. Two wingers unable to telepathically link up with each other.
More. Still scrum advantage.
And it's very clear that that is a maul, so Oxford just have a little bit of
no
tidying there.
No advantage from the knock on by White. Ball not coming out, scrum blue.
There you go, it was the original knock-on that we were playing advantage for, so it is going to be a scrum then to Oxford. More conversations going on there for Jack Baird.
Crouch. Bind.
Not long left then.
Set.
And huge scrummage for Oxford after the last one where the penalty was given. Much more solid base this time.
Trot then. Oh, it was a lovely pass away there by Trot, but it was forwards.
Yeah, it was very, very clear forward pass. Great decision, poor execution. Ball definitely went forward.
And it looks like we're going to have a late change here also for Cambridge. Coming off the field of play is Gabriella Johansson, and coming on is Katarina Sanchez-Schilling, the American student.
And exactly what Oxford wouldn't want to see at this point. They're already creaking at the scrummage to bring fresh legs on as well. Cambridge will be thinking, right, what is our absolute best backline move that we can run off this scrummage? And I expect they're going to try and get the ball to Alice Middleton.
5 minutes left then in the women's varsity. Just 3 points in it. Great tackle coming in there by Ashley Loken. She's put in quite a few of them so far today.
Yeah, she's been immense for Oxford in defence, hasn't she?
Hacked on by Oxford. Middleton collects. And one thing you can't deny, whatever happens from this Oxford performance, the defence has held so far. It's been very impressive. Big hits keep raining in on the Cambridge players. There's the handoff by him. Still going, still flying away is Lara Gibson. Big hit again by Sophie Trott.
Team blue roll. No time.
Onto the 22. Time running out for Cambridge. What can they do here? That was Pratt, and Oxford think they have it, and they do. Not the best box kick that Carly Bliss has ever got away with, but it's still out of play. And look at Carly Bliss. She's trying to do that thing where you disguise that you're slightly winded by pulling her socks up.
Yeah, that didn't hurt at all. It's all Cambridge though, isn't it, at the moment?
Still smiling.
In the line-out, the ball must be thrown down the middle of the line-out, which we call straight. If it's not straight, it is thrown down to one side more than the other and an unfair contest, then it's not straight. In the tackle now, you often see two people tackle the ball carrier. The player who remains on his feet, once the ball carrier has gone to ground, the player remains on his feet and in contact with him, must release him before he can regather the ball. If he doesn't, then we call that assist tackle and not releasing, and that is a penalty offence. In rugby, you must make an effort to tackle your opponent below the line of the shoulder and below the neck. If you don't, then it's a high tackle. Head check is if a referee suspects a player has been concussed in the game and would like him to get checked, then he calls a medic by making the head check signal. If you have an open wound and you're bleeding, then you must leave the field for that blood wound to be stopped. And that is 15 minutes, and the referee will signal if it's a blood wound, because the blood wound player can be replaced temporarily for that 15 minutes while he's being treated for the blood. A free kick is awarded for an infringement that is deemed not to be as deliberate as a penalty offence, and that would be, for example, a lot of people would say it's deliberate. If the scrum half feeds the ball in the scrum, not putting in straight, that's a free kick. Hooker having his foot up before the ball comes in is a free kick. The ball must travel at least 5 metres and straight in the line out. If it doesn't travel 5 metres, then that's a free kick as well. And also, a referee will give a free kick when a player calls a mark. You can only call your mark from directly from a kick in your own 22. Neck roll and neck grab is something quite new which has been creeping into the game. It's dangerous play where players grab players by the neck in the mauls or in the contact area to take them out, or they grab them around the neck to twist them out of the contact area, which shouldn't be happening because it's very dangerous play. So that's classed as a high tackle, dangerous play, neck roll or neck grab, and that is to be penalised and to be clamped down on.
Jack Baird.
Crouch. Bind.
Not long left then.
Set.
And huge scrummage for Oxford after the last one, where the penalty was given. Much more solid base this time.
Trott then. Oh, lovely pass away there by Trott, but it was forwards.
Yeah, it was very, very clear forward pass. Great decision, poor execution. Ball definitely went forward.
And it looks like we're going to have a late change here also for Cambridge. Coming off the field of play is Gabriella Johansson, and coming on is Katarina Sanchez-Schilling, the American student.
And exactly what Oxford wouldn't want to see at this point. They're already creaking at the scrummage to bring fresh legs on as well. Cambridge will be thinking, right, what is our absolute best backline move that we can run off this scrummage? And I expect they're going to try and get the ball to Alice Middleton.
5 minutes left then in the women's varsity. Just 3 points in it. Great tackle coming in there by Ashley Loken. She's put in quite a few of them so far today.
Yeah, she's been immense for Oxford in defence, hasn't she?
Hacked on by Oxford. Middleton collects. And one thing you can't deny, whatever happens from this Oxford performance, the defence has held so far. It's been very impressive. Big hits keep raining in on the Cambridge players. There's the handoff by... still going, still flying away is Lara Gibson. Big hit again by Sophie Trott.
Team blue roll.
Onto the 22. Time running out for Cambridge. What can they do here? That was Pratt, and Oxford think they have it, and they do. Not the best box kick that Carly Bliss has ever got away with, but it's still out of play. And look at Carly Bliss. She's trying to do that thing where you disguise that you're slightly winded by pulling a socks up.
Yeah, that didn't hurt at all. It's all Cambridge though, isn't it, at the moment?
Still smiling, Sophie Trott.
Time off.
Still happily looking around, enjoying the experience. Who's going to enjoy that experience a little bit more in the next 3 minutes?
Yes. Replacement,
well,
please.
Sophie Evans is going to be coming on then. And it looks like that is the end of Kate Mark's day. So Kate Marks makes her way off the field of play. So this is now a permanent replacement. And Sophie Evans is on.
10 metres, please.
Suggest Charlton. gets the ball in. Comes away. It's going to be coming through this time, flying away. Round the corner, they go again.
Blue tacklers release! Rock. Blue tackler release.
3 minutes left. Still Cambridge ball. Byrne looks up. Oh, knock on at the worst of opportunities by Suggett.
No hands!
I think the referee's deemed that's gone backwards. But it's an Oxford ball. Jennifer Smith's going to try and
rock.
Go route one.
Use it!
That is out.
You can hear the referee shouting really clearly, use it, can't you?
Bliss to Wilcock.
Scrum advantage.
Is that a knock on again? Yes, it is. Just saw the hands go up onto the head there of Catherine Wilcock, the Oxford captain, and say, no, not again, not again. Less than 2 minutes to go.
Yeah, it's the inexperience. Don't. There's no point taking chances there. Just take the ball in, recycle it. This is a huge attacking opportunity for Cambridge. A really solid scrummage. Alice Middleton lurking, ready to pounce. Are Oxford equal to it, or can Cambridge produce one last piece of attacking flair?
Time is against Cambridge. Oxford just need to let this defensive line hold. Byrne just appealing there to the players to get out of the way. I can't see is what she's saying. Charlton loses the ball. It's been hacked on though by Middleton. Here's a little foot chase. Sophie Trott gathers. She needs to get it away, and she does. She gets the clearance. It will be a Cambridge put-in, but this is likely to be the last passage of play.
That was excellent, excellent play from Sophie Trott. The calmness with which she did that. Players bearing down on her. You're so in two minds. Do I wait for the ball to come out of the line so I can touch it down? Do I pick it up? She did brilliantly there.
And as we wait for this line out, Sue, your player of the match for the women's varsity.
Yeah, there's been a few standout players, but the player who was just on the ball there, Sophie Trott, she's been so calm and collected. She's kept Oxford in the game with all those tackles.
Sniped away down this near side. It's Charlton who's going. She's going to be hurled out as well. And there will be one more line-out, but it will be an Oxford line-out.
Yeah, Sophie Trott's kept Oxford in the game. She's been a great attacking threat, but even more important in defence. Other players who have stood out, of course, Alice Middleton for Cambridge. For Oxford, Carly Bliss has been absolutely crucial. Elmarie van Heerden absolutely outstanding in the pack, but Sophie Trott the standout.
It's loose on the floor. Carly Bliss has it. She needs to run it out of play. She does. Will they go for the line-out, or will they say there's still time for it? Carly Bliss thought the clock had gone. Oh, they are going to play. We will have one more line-out in this varsity match. Cambridge are throwing one last lifeline. Big moment. Tight at the front. Is this going to be the perfect maul? Byrne has it. She's going to get it away. Charlton again. The defence has to hold. A referee says no. She is saying it was not coming correctly. And Oxford have done it. They have won back the varsity trophy in the most incredible
afternoon. Assisted by Ross Campbell and Bill Waters, the TMO, David Rose. It is our final kickoff on Christmas Eve in the Aviva Premiership, and it's Owen Williams to get us underway here at Sandy Park. A loud call from Jack Knoll, wanting to immediately get in on the action and burst through, slices his way past Harrison, hacks the ball down to that left-hand touchline where it's chased back here by Peter Beetham. Ushered into touch, and what a start that is for the Chiefs, and in particular for Jack Knoll. Demonstrating exactly what he can do from the outset, scything his way through the Tigers defence, and then a fine kick down there towards the edge of the 22. The Tigers line out then immediately on the back foot. George McGuigan picks out his man, Mike Fitzgerald, and the ball formed by the Tigers. But from the restart. Ball collected by Johnny Hill. Drives it up towards halfway. Chudley releases. Here goes Waldrum.
Ripped!
Ball ripped away from him though, and it's a good turnover here from Lesser and bursting forward. Nice little break there from Jack Roberts. Thompson comes in and fills in as the scrum half. McQuiggan driving over the ball. Harrison there again. Fed back Williams and Freddie Burns with some smart footwork to get the ball through. And it dribbles out into touch.
Nice big touch.